Unused content, extra rooms, extra textures, places that you can never go in the game, at least without perhaps hacking the game or something like that. The unused world and items behind the game. Are they a bug? Are they the result of deadlines? Is it good work? Is it bad work? What is it? Hi folks, it's Falcon, and today on GameRanks we ask the question, why do video games have unused data on the disc? So first, I want to provide an example. We actually talked about this in a video on our channel already, but there's a lot of hidden rooms in Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. Using an emulator, hacking the ROM a little bit, changing certain things around, loading different things, you can get into a bunch of strange rooms. Some of them have placeholder textures, some of them have much more developed motifs, but pretty much none of them are just entirely completed rooms. It's certainly not the only example. Most Bethesda games have some unused content on the discs, but it's definitely the first one that comes into my mind. When I think unused content, I think Ocarina rooms. But why is that still there? How are we able to even get into that stuff? Well, when you're developing a game, you have artists making assets at a fairly high rate. That's all they do. 3D artists make 3D objects, 2D artists make textures, and they just keep going and going and going. They get some spec sheets, they get some requests, they're filled in on what's needed, and they just go for it. At some point, all of that has to be unified and smoothed over and made sure that it seems like one thing, one singular world, and that art styles match up at least on a level that won't be questioned. But development yields a rapidly increasing number of assets. Those assets are used to construct the game, and often during the course of a game, such as a game with rooms like Legend of Zelda, rooms are used, then substituted out, then reused somewhere else, or substituted out, or left alone, or whatever, and they're left in a folder. And there may be code that calls for those assets. It may load those assets. And rooms or maps or assets may be looked at as a possible inclusion of the game up until the final stretch of game development. And at that point, if they're still in the code, they're probably gonna leave it on the disc. Here's why. For a moment, let's talk about how a bug gets into a game. A AAA game, which is where you most see the unused asset phenomenon, is a very complex development process, and often not necessarily entirely unified. So as many people are making various additions to the same code, day in, day out for several years, sometimes certain pieces of code rely on certain other pieces of code, and maybe there's a bug in that code. But if that code is removed, nothing works. Now, this is obviously oversimplified, but in a lot of cases, this is why a bug is in a final version of a game. The company doesn't want to end up paying people for an extra month of work specifically to isolate one little thing that they can do later in a patch. A patch that might address other things as well, such as paving the way for downloadable content, for instance. So the reason why unused content such as empty rooms and uncoded weapons, textures, etc., the reason why that stuff ends up on the CD or the DVD or the Blu-ray or the downloadable content package, I don't know, I just thought it was good to say all of those formats at once. Look how far we've come so fast. The reason why it ends up there is not unlike the reason why you still have bugs in a quote-unquote finished product, because technically removing them is work. Other things may be dependent on the line of code that includes it. There's a possibility that taking things out may cause other problems because of those dependencies, essentially because of the way the games are put together, which is frankly a little bit fragmented. You have many teams of people working together in a manner where they just continually commit new things to a repository, or at least whatever the proprietary equivalent of that is within the company that's doing the development work. As things are added, they're often not subtracted on account other things are built in a manner that is using those things. It doesn't necessarily make sense to just remove the loading process for something when you start having large, complex arrays of code being continually combined and hoping that it works. To put it in a different way, it's easier to stitch things together than it is to cut out large parts and make new parts. And while that may sound like perhaps taking the easy way, it's not necessarily. Development is a very long process, like I said, and involves an extremely large number of factors. For a Grand Theft Auto game, for instance, you're talking about a large number of people, assets, code, etc. If the game's working near the end of things, taking out a room that nobody's ever going to actually see isn't exactly a high priority. You have to remember there's a QA team, a quality assurance team that's constantly testing the game, and the things that they're finding are going to be much higher priority than the things that, well, are definitely not going to be seen unless somebody hacks the game. Remember, every single minute contributes to the game's overall budget, and if there's days or weeks spent on removing a thing and making sure that everything else still works, that's kind of a waste of money if the thing doesn't actually affect the game. And while some people might make the case for perfectionism, I'd like to make the case that people's time is valuable. Workers doing labor do have a right to be paid in exchange for their labor. And because of this, a company kind of has to make a few decisions. What's worthwhile labor? Is this a waste of this person's time? Is it a waste of our money to commit that person to this waste of time? Is anybody really going to be that mad there's an extra room in this dungeon that they'll never see? If it's something that doesn't actually cause any kind of anger or upset or disturbance in the gameplay, and removing it may or may not cause everything to not work, it's better to just leave it there. So that's basically the logistical human reason why there is extra content on a disc. Game development is kind of a house of cards. It doesn't make any sense to start experimenting with which cards won't knock the whole thing down to pull out near the end of the development cycle. If this makes sense to you or you have something to add, perhaps you're a developer yourself or just have some other insight to share, I'd love to talk with you in the comments about that. If you like this video, please click like, and if you're not subscribed, now would be a great time to do so. We upload brand new videos every single day of the week, and the best way to see them first is, of course, a subscription. As always, we thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Falcon. You can follow me on Twitter @FalconTheHero, and we'll see you next time right here on GameRanks.